Hello and welcome, it's Chris here. In this three-part video series, my friend Flo is going to help us compare macOS app development versus iOS app development. You're going to see what things you can use across the two platforms, as well as what is specific to the macOS platform. Now, I think you're going to learn a lot, and I think you're going to really enjoy yourself. So make sure you stay tuned next week for part two. And if you like Flo's teaching style, make sure you check out his YouTube channel, Flo Writes Code. All right, enjoy.
Learn about how you can bring your existing SwiftUI skills to the Mac. Hey Code Crew, this is Flo. This is the first lesson of the SwiftUI on macOS mini course. In this lesson, we will cover the different approaches of writing macOS apps with SwiftUI. Have a look at how we can share code between the different operating systems and how certain components might behave a little bit different. So first of all, I have already prepared a little example project for this lesson because we will not actually be writing any code today. I will just show you how things work, which things behave differently, which things are exactly the same as you might have already known them from iOS development. So first of all, the general principles of SwiftUI and the development environment are exactly the same. You're still using views, you still have vstacks, navigation views, lists, and so on. Everything behaves exactly the same. So you basically write the exact same style of code. Other things like the environment, user defaults, and core data also behave exactly the same across the platforms. Of course, there are some limitations. For example, HealthKit just isn't available on the Mac, which is available on iOS, but most of the other things are exactly the same. Now, there's one major difference between iOS and macOS development, and that's the underlying framework of SwiftUI. So as you probably know, on iOS, SwiftUI is built on top of UIKit. So if you have to step down into something, it's usually UI view representables that you have to write, or UI view controller representables, where then inside you create some UI views, for example, for a photo picker or stuff like that. Now on the Mac, there is no UIKit, so it just simply doesn't exist. The native framework for the Mac is called AppKit, and it's actually very similar to UIKit, with the main difference being the naming. So instead of creating UI view representables, you will be creating NS view representables. So where in UIKit, the prefix is always UI, in AppKit, the prefix will always be NS for Next Step, that company that Steve Jobs founded and then was later bought back by Apple. So you have to keep that in mind. When you use some UIKit hacks, for example, in your SwiftUI app for iOS, they will not work and they won't even compile on macOS just because UIKit doesn't exist there. So you can transfer all your skills with the view representables. Just make sure that you use the NS version instead of the UI version. For this next section, let's have a look at how you can actually create a macOS app. So of course, you create a new project in Xcode, as always, but now there are basically three different options for you to choose from. The first option is to create a standalone macOS app. This is the standard option if you just want to create a macOS app that shouldn't be run on any other operating system. So if you want to create an app that only runs on the Mac and not on, for example, an iPad or an iPhone, then you should choose the macOS tab and then select App. Another option is to create a multi-platform app. This will basically add two targets to your app. First, the iOS target to run your app on iPhones and iPads, and then also the macOS target to run your app on the Mac. With this approach, you can share a lot of your code, but you still have the option to write some specific code or some files that are only inside of one of the two targets. So if you select multi-platform here at the top tab bar and then app, you will have a project with a shared folder. This is where most of your logic, maybe your database access, your services, most of your views will live in this shared folder. But then you will also have a folder for iOS specific code and for macOS specific code. And then the last option is Mac Catalyst. So in this case, you will just create an iOS app. So select iOS in the tab bar here and then app below. And this will allow you to enable the Catalyst environment. What that basically does is it allows you to write a regular iPad app. So an app that runs on the iPhone and or the iPad, but it has to run on the iPad with SwiftUI. And you can also use UIKit for that. And then this will be translated into a Catalyst app that can be run on the Mac. So if you really just don't want to dive into all that NS and AppKit stuff, you can just still use your SwiftUI and UIKit knowledge and build a Catalyst app. Now, I will repeat here, the important part is that a Catalyst app needs to include the iPad, not only the iPhone. Let's have a look inside Xcode and see how you can select all of these things. So, for example, in this project that I prepared, it's a multi-platform project. So there is a shared folder here and also a macOS folder. Now, in this case, there is no iOS folder because there are just no iOS specific files right now. But if you had to create some iOS specific code, you would then also have an iOS folder. Let's get into the project file. And there you can see on the left hand side here in the left panel, there is an iOS target for the SwiftUI on Mac app and a macOS target. I have actually done something very interesting for this project, and I have enabled Catalyst and a native Mac version of the app. So the macOS target here is basically the native macOS target. But if we switch to the iOS target and then have a look here at the center pane, then you will see that I have selected the iPad as a deployment target, and I have also activated Mac Catalyst. What this does is it gives me two options to compile and run this app. In reality, you would probably never do this. Usually, either you use Catalyst or you create your own macOS target. Both at the same time really only make sense right now for this video, so I can show you the differences between them. Okay, so since we have two targets in this project, if we click on the Scheme Manager here, we can select either the iOS target or the macOS target. As I said, macOS target, plain macOS project can only be run on the Mac native application. But since I have selected Catalyst in the iOS target, I can even run the iOS target on my Mac now. So if I just select my Mac Catalyst here, then I can just run the iOS app on my Mac like I would run any other Mac app. So it's important for you to understand the differences between the three approaches. Either you create a standalone Mac app, or you create a multi-platform app where you share code between macOS and iOS, but you also have specific files to either of those targets. And then the third approach via the iPad app and Mac Catalyst turns on. Now, I have already created a few views for this example app because I want to show you the differences between a Catalyst app and a plain Mac app. So let me run both of them and show you the differences. Okay, so I'm starting with the native Mac app. And let's have a look at how all of the inputs behave there, how the navigation view behaves there, the titles, and so on. So you can see here the app is running. We have a navigation title at the top, SwiftUI on Mac. This is just the app's title. Then we have a default screen here. You have to pay attention when you're developing Mac apps because the navigation view actually behaves the same as on the iPad, where you always have a sidebar and a main view. It's not the same as on iOS or on iPhones where you have a navigation stack where views get stacked on top of each other. So on macOS, we have just a simple text here, a navigation link, and then another text here. We will get into how this text came about in just a second. And then we also have our sidebar here where we can navigate either to this second tab or to the first tab where I have just prepared a few of the standard SwiftUI input elements, because those are the things that actually behave pretty differently from case to case from iOS to macOS. So I have some buttons with button styles, bordered button style, bordered prominent button style. There is a toggle, there is a picker, and you can see on macOS the standard picker is like a popover menu. Then I also have a date picker here, a color picker, which opens up this little window. All of these are default elements of SwiftUI on the Mac. And then I also have this little slider and a stepper that's connected to the same value as the slider, basically. So keep in mind how all of these look, and now we will jump into the Mac Catalyst version of the app and see the differences. Okay, so the Catalyst version of the app is now running, and there are some immediate differences. For example, the sidebar now doesn't have that translucent background effect. So with the macOS native app, you always have that standard sidebar with the translucency where you can somehow see a blurred version of what's behind the window. This is not the case in Catalyst apps, because that just doesn't exist on the iPad. Basically, a Catalyst app is just an iPad app compiled to be run on the Mac. Okay, so you can see already a bunch of differences. The navigation bar looks a little bit different. The navigation link here looks a little bit different. You can see that this text label here also has a different content, but as I said, I will show you that in just a second. We also have this little toggle here on the left-hand side to open and hide the sidebar, which is not there by default on the Mac. Then we also have a navigation title here in the sidebar. And then we have both of our navigation links. So the first one to the destination 2, basically the same as before, but the title once again behaves differently from the Mac version. And then that input screen looks really different in my opinion. Let me make that a bit bigger. So you can see the button styles are similar, but different. So here's the border button style and the border prominent button style. They don't have that 3D-like effect as they had in the macOS version. The toggle also is completely different. It's actually a toggle, whereas on macOS it was more like a checkbox. The picker has a completely different style compared to the Mac. Of course, you can set the picker style to be a menu picker style, but by default, it will just have a different behavior. The date picker also looks different. The color picker is really huge for some reason, but it still opens the same color picker window here. And then the stepper also looks a bit different, but the slider is pretty much the same. So what you should take away from these two examples is you can create a Catalyst version of your app and run it on the Mac. It will probably work just fine, but some of the standard input elements will have a different appearance or sometimes also a different behavior. The last thing that I want to show to you in this lesson are preprocessor macros. As I already told you, when you have a multi-platform app, you can share your code between the iOS and the macOS codebase. Now, some things are just not possible to share because iOS doesn't have AppKit and macOS doesn't have UIKit. So things like UI color just don't exist on the Mac. There is an equivalent NS color, but it's not the same. So you can't write exactly the same code for some of these things. What you can do, however, is use preprocessor macros to determine which part of your code is run on which platform. So in this example, I have added a check for the platform. So if the OS is macOS, then the text on our first view on that content view screen shows I'm running on macOS. And if it's not OS macOS, then it shows I'm not running on macOS. Now let me run both of my targets again and show you a very interesting difference. Okay, so now I have selected the native macOS target in Xcode. And here you can see the text table will say I'm running on macOS because we had that preprocessor macro check here. If the OS is macOS, then say I'm running on macOS. This makes sense. It is a macOS app. So let's try the same thing with the Catalyst version of the app. Okay, so now I have run the Catalyst version. And as you can see, the text label says I'm not running on macOS. And this is the subtle but very important difference. Catalyst is an iOS app run on the Mac. So the app itself uses all of the iOS specific code. It is still using UIKit in your code, which then gets compiled into AppKit probably. I don't know exactly how that works, but here you can see the main difference between a macOS target and a Catalyst target. It's just not the same. You can write very similar code, but it will behave differently. Okay. So in this lesson, you got an overview of what working on macOS apps with SwiftUI really means. You learned about Catalyst versus native apps and how to share code between supported platforms in a single code base.